contained in this book that I referred to, found on pages 441 to 451, you will find the large number of writers that we now have and their body of work that they have produced. So in the last 50 years or so, it might be fair to say that the writing of Sri Lankan women has blossomed and bloomed, especially in poetry and fiction in the form of the short story. It has been noted that women's writing at the very beginning was confined to a minority of English-speaking members of the westernized upper class. Siromi Fernando and Raihana Rahim, writing some time ago, have referred to this aspect of Sri Lankan writing in English by women. They were economically well-off, lived comfortable lives, had domestic help, and hence all the leisure as compared with women from less privileged backgrounds for writing. But in the last almost seven decades since independence, one could argue that the situation has certainly changed for the better. Even after numbers increased, neglect and marginalized by the critical male-dominated establishment, according to Yasmin Dharatna, has posed a challenge. Because women's writing was considered by these critics as limited in experience, I'm using words that they use, I don't necessarily agree with them, limited in experience and womanly in expression. Mothers and women are expected to be unwomanly in their expression and non-scientific in content. In fairness, it needs to be pointed out that such thinking at that particular point in time and history was universal and not confined to Sri Lanka alone. In the rest of Asia, Europe, and even in the United States, give or take a little, the situation was pretty similar. The general idea of the time was that natural talents of women are limited to reflections of domestic life and autobiographical experience, an idea that is today, I think, long out of date. Equally out of date, preposterous as it may sound, is the suggestion that the proper sphere of women is domestic. Smooth running of households and the rearing of docile and obedient children. We need to also bear in mind that writing in English, not only by women, but by all Sri Lankans, in the course of our literary development, has had a hard time in gaining recognition and acceptance. The combined efforts of writers and critics, such as the late Dick and Pauline Hensman, Lord Tribunathilaka, Regis Srivardhana, Ashley Halke, Ranjini Obesekara, Yasmin Gunaratna, Lakshmi De Silva, Ranjan Gunatilaka, or DCRA Gunatilaka, as is more famously known, Kamal Diablo, Thirukandaiya, Derek Kissi.